So, smartphones in... Wait, something's missing. Something's missing. It's not that bad. Don't ask me what I'm wearing below. Anyways, the 25K smartphone segment in India is where most smartphones are getting launched these days and red hot, like the candles outside. Happy Diwali to all TechWiser family and wish you a very happy and safe Diwali. And here, come here, on smartphones, here's a little insider news. Not many phones are launching until next year, January. So you have newly launched phones like Mi 11 Lite NE 5G, iQOO Z5, Samsung M52 5G, and OnePlus Nord CE. So, which is the right smartphone for you? Well, this is Pratik, and after watching this video, you will have a crystal clear idea of which smartphone to buy if you have a budget of 25,000. And for that clarity, let's race to 600K before December. Subscribe to TechWiser, hit the bell icon as well. And yes, it's not that we are just picking a random list of smartphones from Amazon. We have the device, we have used them thoroughly. You can see reviews, comparison of them individually on the channel. So fair game. And we would be dividing these smartphones into tiers. And thank you guys. You guys have been loving the tier system. And I believe as a buyer, it gives you really great clarity. So there has to be a good tier, which is the best smartphone for a long time. Then you have the very solid tier, which again is a phone that is better in most of the aspects, but a bit average in one of the aspects. Like you have good performance and camera, but a bit average software. Then you have the does the job tier, which is a phone great in only one aspect, but average in most of the aspects. Like you have really good performance, but the camera, the display is average. And then finally, you know it, I know it. Don't buy phones in this category. Not at all recommended, unless I say so. So Xiaomi really hyped the Mi 11 Lite NE 5G for two things, lightweight and 5G. In fact, it is the slimmest phone in this segment. Like it's 6.81 mm. And here, if you look at the weight, freaking 159 grams. I haven't held a phone this slim, so kudos. It's a really good looking phone and handy. I would say probably the best looking in this entire list. Now, if you go by the specs, the display is 10-bit and Xiaomi also added Dolby Vision to it. The first time in a smartphone in this segment. Now, I've done a video on 10-bit display and its impact on smartphones, but just to summarize. And here, if you look at the display of both the devices playing HANA, this is a dark scene. And if you see, the Samsung M52 can still show highlights on the human faces and overall has better HDR processing than the 10-bit display on the Mi 11 Lite NE 5G. And mind you, Samsung M52 5G is an 8-bit panel. So it's better to prefer a good display panel rather than 10-bit or something. Anyways, it's a good display. Moving on to the cameras on the Mi 11 Lite NE 5G are good. The macro camera especially. Xiaomi gives a 5 megapixel tele macro camera and that is just killer. Like have a look. Macro photos are really good. It tries to make a swirly bokeh around the subject which looks really dope. And normal cameras are also good. We'll get to the camera portion in just a moment. And one good thing is Xiaomi is improving on bugs in MIUI. I actually for the first time didn't see a whole lot of bugs in the UI. Like you still have that control center glitch once in a while, but the UI on the whole is fairly smooth. Xiaomi has also promised 3 years of Android updates and 4 years of security updates on Mi 11 Lite 5G. That's great to hear. Now the only complaint is system updater. It sends me notifications to update my system. You step in and you see it's asking you to update the install app in Xiaomi's own app store. And this page itself has a lot of recommendations. Not cool. I know these can be disabled, but then again, it shouldn't be there in the first place. I'll put Mi 11 Lite 5G in the very solid tier. I mean, you have a good display, looks, really good software for starters. This is not for hardcore gamers. There are better options in the market if you're looking for a gaming phone, but for rest of them, it's a really good option. And talking about performance, iQOO Z5 is next up. And I'm not just saying it. Here, have a look. All of them are Snapdragon 778G phones, but iQOO Z5 scores a lot more in benchmarks. And not just benchmarks. I also thoroughly tested the gaming performance in a video right over here. The thermal performance and cooling of the phone is really great compared to other Snapdragon 778G phones. Now, iQOO Z5 has put up a cooling layer and really OP'd the Snapdragon 778G. Plus, my favorite, you have a headphone jack. Now, since this is a gaming phone, you expect a couple of things. The camera, number one. The camera on the iQOO Z5 isn't the best in this range. I could easily put it around OnePlus Nord CE. We'll get to OnePlus Nord CE. Number two, the LCD screen. Now, having an LCD screen isn't bad. It's a good 120Hz LCD panel which gets enough bright outdoors, but most people will prefer an AMOLED over LCD, including me. I would say if you want a gaming phone, spend a bit more and get the iQOO 7 instead. I would put iQOO Z5 in the does the job tier. It's really good for gaming and thermal performance, and given that many people have bought it on an early bird price of just 21k, it's a good deal at 21,000. Now, this might be Samsung's really good launch considering the previous track record of M series launched in 2021, the M52 5G. Now, before you go out on me, listen carefully. Although being 7 out of 10 at best, Samsung still has a really good balanced main sensor at this price. Hold on, let me just click photos right now to show you how good it is. And now see all the photos right here. The Mi 11 Lite and Samsung M52 5G has better HDR processing and proper white balance. The Note CE is more cool for the actual scene. iQOO Z5 is just noisy if you zoom in. And yeah, Kaushal and Kaushik were shooting the Windows video, K-Square. I took some time from them. Note CE has really bad skin tone, and Samsung is the most closest to Kaushal and Kaushik's real life skin tone. Like, it was the only camera which got Kaushik's skin tone right. Samsung camera processing is quite good in this range, and it's not just one off case. Kaushal has a really good comparison between the Samsung M52 5G and Mi 11 Lite 5G. You can check it out here. It's in Hindi though. And to add to it, I would say M52 5G has the best 120Hz display in and around 25,000. Now, like everything else in life, this phone isn't perfect. The overall performance of this phone is average. Like here, if you see the overall sluggishness of the UI or just camera opening time. BGMI gameplay is also below average. Like, you should look for other options if gaming is your priority. I have a dedicated review of the Samsung M52 5G. You can check that out for more clarity. Also, Samsung ships in a 15W charger with the phone, even though the phone supports 25W charging. Other devices in this range give you 33W or even 65W charging. I think a 15W charger is comparatively less. So I'll put Samsung M52 5G in the very solid tier. See, it has a good display, in-hand feel, battery, camera. The only average part is performance. And talking about average performance, we have Note CE. See, I was most hyped about this phone in 2021. It is probably the cheapest OnePlus phone out there. We have done reviews and comparison of Note CE before, which you can check out from here. And it does have a good 90Hz display. Like, I would agree, the display is really good. And the treat for which you will buy the phone is OxygenOS. It is still the original OxygenOS for time being. Clean, bloat-free. OnePlus has also promised 2 years of Android updates and 3 years of security updates. Currently, you have the latest September security update, so that's on track. And we are tracking this for you. No worries. Subscribe so that you don't miss out on that massive software update video. But the major concern for me is camera. The camera is a bit below average, I would say. OnePlus has to do a lot of work on color science. The human subjects mostly turn out pinkish or with weird skin tones. Now, the camera can be improved with a G cam because you have Snapdragon 750G here, but I'm judging it on the stock OnePlus camera app. And most importantly, OxygenOS is not at all optimized for the phone. In my day-to-day usage, I see there were a bit of bugs, as well as the day-to-day usage was really laggy. So if you're someone who really needs a OnePlus phone, I would say extend the budget and get a Note 2 instead. And also, OnePlus Note CE, it goes to you know it, I know it tier, because most importantly, the phone was launched for 23,000, but the base variant is only available in one color, and that also goes out of stock once in a while. So you are stuck with OnePlus Note CE at 25,000. That's not cool. Now we have a wildcard entry in this list. Listen carefully. The Realme GT Neo 2 starts at 31,999 for the 8 128GB variant. However, Flipkart is offering 4,000 extra on exchange offers. Like, for example, we bought it exchanging iPhone SE and we got back almost 9.5K for iPhone SE. 9,500, which brings the price of Realme GT Neo at 22,599. Now at 22,000, Realme GT Neo 2 is the best phone you can get for performance. Even if you're not able to exchange the device because Flipkart for somehow doesn't want a dent on your previous device, then you can avail an instant discount of 4,000 rupees on any non-prepaid offers. Now, there's also Mi 11X, which has the same Snapdragon 870. Usually, it is sold for 28,000. You also get lots of exchange and discount offers, which brings the price to around 21,000-22,000. Same discount offer and tempting as well, but I would say get the GT Neo 2 over this. It has better cameras. Definitely a wise choice. So yeah, I'll put the Realme GT Neo 2 in GOAT territory considering the Snapdragon 870 at 21,000. I don't think we'll see a 870 phone at that price. Plus, Snapdragon is not updating 870 anytime soon due to the chip shortage. Mi 11X on the other hand goes to you know it, I know it tier. Don't buy it unless you're getting it way less at 18-20,000. That's how we bought it. We'll in the future do the best processor in this range or speed test under 30k. If you guys are up for it, that will clear a lot of confusion. So I hope your doubts were clear, and I love making this smartphone under X series. It gives you a clear idea and makes my life a bit better. Now just to summarize, for performance and gaming, iQOO Z5 is a good option. If you want an AMOLED with performance, Realme GT Neo 2 is also a good option. For more casual users, I would recommend Samsung M52 5G. And if and only if you're going to custom ROM your device, Mi 11 Lite NE 5G is a really good option even for casual users. Rest all smartphone, just don't worry. And have a happy and safe Diwali, man. Stay with the family, have lots of sweet, have a good time. The team is really working hard to put content during the festival, so just like it for Team TechWiser. This is Pratik signing off. See you pretty soon.